please welcome our rocket scientist, Jeff Norris.
Thank you. The Saturn V, the rocket that we eventually used, at the time it was built, was the tallest building in the state of Florida. Well, technically, there was only one larger building, and that was the building that held the Saturn V. But the Saturn V was driven down a road on wheels and then launched into space. So they launched the largest building in Florida into space. About your rocket science, it's the thing that you do that sets you apart from your competitors. It's the thing that you daydream about. It's the thing you're actually being paid to do. It's the point of it all.
When he was starting out his work on the telephone, got a hold of a book by Helmholtz, who's a German scientist. Alexander Graham Bell did not read German, but he looked at the pictures and tried to piece together what he thought Helmholtz had done. And what he thought he had done was that Helmholtz had sent vowels, parts of speech, across a wire. Helmholtz had done nothing of the kind. Alexander Graham Bell began to labor to reproduce an experiment that had never been accomplished, and ultimately succeeded in building the telephone. And I want just you to reflect on that for a moment. Sometimes merely, even falsely, believing that something has been done or something is possible is all that is necessary to engender great creativity and vision.
The unavoidable nature of risk in hard things, the unavoidable nature of risk in any major enterprise, in your business. The need, however, to understand it and embrace it, not to run away from it, but to study it, analyze it, and make a science of it. We trade risk at NASA like it's a currency, like money, like fuel, like battery voltage, like every other currency that we have on our spacecraft. Risk is not something that you avoid at all costs. It simply has a cost, one that you have to manage.
That was great.
Thank you very much.
That was really great.
Thank you.
I enjoyed that. Okay, my first question, how'd you do that?